Hello everyone, this is Athena. I'm back with another video. We have been continuously sharing the updates on the slots availability through community post or via videos. And today we are going to see the operation status of US Embassy and Consulate in India in terms of slots availability for this week and how it is going to be or what is expected in coming weeks. And moreover, we are also going to see what's happening with the Dropbox eligibility criteria of 48 months expiry. If an individual is already eligible for Dropbox, is there any way that he can make an emergency appointment? In fact, is he really eligible to raise an emergency request or not? And whom to reach out if you have any queries or if your account gets locked? So let's get into the video for more updates. If you have been following this channel, I think you might have seen continuous update on the operation status of US Embassy and Consulate in India in terms of slots availability and visa priorities. Due to this pandemic, the entire year of 2021 was like a roller coaster ride for many applicants who have been waiting to get their stamping done or who had the plan to travel to US or even travel back to India. But then, looking at how it was in the entire year, this month, December, is actually very nice and excited to see so many slots to be opened. Especially starting December 5th, we have been seeing the slots opened for Dropbox B1, B2 or work visa like H, L visa. People have been continuously updating that they were able to get the slots for early next year. And the slots have been opened for January, Feb and in fact, till end of March, the slots were opened and many were able to get the slots. As I was making this video, even one of my friends have scheduled an appointment in Chennai for H1B. So looks like as per the announcement from the consulate, they are planning to open the slots till May. So if you are looking to travel to India by early of next year, then start checking for slots. You might be able to grab one very soon. In our previous video, we have already updated that Dropbox appointment for B1, B2 has been kickstarted after 7 months. And it is absolutely a happy news for the people who have been waiting to schedule for B1, B2. And it is not only for Dropbox B1, B2, they have already opened slots, bunch and bunch of slots for work visa as well, including H and L visa categories. By seeing the number of slots, the consulate is getting ready to increase the capacity and to accommodate more number of slots for the applicants. And it is absolutely a great news and we are excited to see much more appointments in coming days. If you have not yet scheduled an appointment, don't worry, there are still more slots which will be opened in coming days. And usually, consulate open the appointment slots now and then whenever the conditions allow. So we are just in the early of December and there are still a lot more days left for them to add the slots for early next year. And it is not only the bulk slots they open, there are individual slots as well, which will be available in the entire day, which means any time in the entire day, you will be able to see individual slots as well. So those slots are the appointments which has been cancelled by the applicants who have booked already. And we have seen an update on the work visa and Dropbox B1, B2. So what happened to other visa category, be it like R visa or O visa or C1D or any other visa category? If you feel that there is no update given, please keep checking for the slots availability because the consulate will not give continuous update on when they are opening the slot. Usually, they open the slots whenever the conditions are low, be it any visa category. If there is any update on a particular visa category, we will surely share it with you through a community post or via video. And by seeing the number of slots which has been opened, I think other visa category also will have an opportunity to get the slots. So don't worry, keep checking. And if you fall under the student's visa category and still you are not able to schedule an appointment, you can ask a question. Why there are a lot of slots which has been opened for work visa and Dropbox B1, B2 when the students are still waiting to join the college? So if you are a student and still not able to schedule an appointment, try making an emergency request so that you'll be able to get the stamping done before your college starts. And if you feel that it is getting delayed, maybe even if you raise an emergency request, you are not very sure whether you will get it approved or whether you will be able to get the stamping done before your joining date, then please make sure that you inform the college or university so that they are well aware of what is the reason behind it. And moreover, even the college or the universities in US are well aware of the current situation due to the pandemic and the stamping delays and all that. So if you are informing, they will surely accept the waiver of timing training and all that. And even the consulate always give the top priority for the students, especially the month before the college joining. For example, now the spring semester is going to start up, and that is where they have given the top priority for students in the month of December. So please continue checking, or you can also expedite your request. When it comes to Dropbox appointment, in the month of March, there was a policy which has been announced that they are extending the Dropbox eligibility to 48 months expiry. And this policy is valid till 31st of December 2021. Though many people were able to schedule a Dropbox appointment for early next year, but still they are worried that what will happen if this policy date is not going to be extended? What will happen to the appointment which has been already scheduled? Will there be any possibility for the appointments to get cancelled, or will there be any possibility for the applicants to be asked to reschedule to in-person interview? So this is what making many people worried. But actually, there are a lot of applicants who have raised this query to the consulate. When we called the consulate and raised this query, they said that if you have scheduled an appointment before 31st of December 2021 and have the confirmation of a Dropbox appointment, then you are good to go. And there was another question raised in the FB live session with the head of the consulate, that is there any possibility for the appointments to get cancelled in early of 2022, which means Jan or Feb of 2022. And for that, even the head of the consulate said that unless and until it is within the time limit of 3 months, then they are not having any plans to cancel, unless and until it is going to be different reason. So by looking at the consulate operations in this 1 year during the pandemic, with my understanding, I think if you have already scheduled an appointment and have the appointment confirmation in your hand, then don't worry. Even if there is going to be a cancellation, you still need to wait for the individual mail to be received. So as of now, you need not worry about it. Add on to this, I would like to add few more points to the consulate operations, how it has been in this past 2 months. So actually, the consulate cancelled all the appointments in the month of Jan and Feb of 2022 who have booked their appointments before November 2021. And now they kept it very clear before they opened the bunch of slots which has been opened now in the December 5th or 6th or 7th. They planned it in such a manner that they cleared it everything and opened the new slots. And moreover, when you go for a Dropbox appointment, there is a set of questions that you have to answer. If the consulate have already decided not to extend this new policy of 48 months expiry, then they might have adjusted or changed the Dropbox questions as well. So as they didn't do the changes in the questions, we can understand that it is not going to be changed at least till December 31st. But that is my understanding. Still, we have to wait for the update from the consulate. But don't worry if you have already scheduled an appointment or waiting to schedule an appointment. Go for it when it is already available. And when it comes to Dropbox, if an applicant is already eligible for Dropbox, is there any way that they'll be able to raise an emergency request? The answer is, if you are eligible for Dropbox, then you are not eligible to raise an emergency request. But still, if you have an emergency reason, then drop a mail to the consulate with a justified reason for you to expedite your request. And the consulate will review your reason and they might share you the steps for you to follow to expedite your request. Now that the consulate have opened more number of slots, you might have scheduled an appointment whenever you were able to see the slots, keeping in mind that there is an option for rescheduling. But you have to note that there is a limit for rescheduling, which means after you scheduled an appointment, you have 4 chances for you to reschedule. So make use of the options which has been given so that you can avoid paying the fees again. And the visa application fee is valid till September 2023. So you need not worry about the validity of the fee, even if you are not able to schedule an appointment in this month or in coming months. When you are trying to schedule an appointment, there are high chances for your account to get logged for 72 hours. So if you are in an emergency situation or you don't have much time to schedule an appointment, then you can unlock your account by either dropping a mail to support-india@ustraveldocs.com, or you can also reach out to them via the phone numbers. I will drop the information in the description as well, so that your account gets unlocked within 24 hours or 48 hours. If you ask me, is this useful? Will they be able to unlock the account? The answer is yes. Even few of our friends have used this option and unlocked their account within 24 hours. So these are the updates that we have for today. And if you're looking for the slots, then keep checking, because the slots might get opened anytime. And don't lock your account as well. You can also keep checking the community post, because we are trying to share as much as information as possible too. So please stay tuned to the Purna Aarthi Vlog for more and more updates on embassy, immigration, travel and vlogs. Stay healthy, stay safe. Take care. Bye-bye.